Oh, we were just talking about summer and pets, and we're so engulfed in our conversation with Dr. Jill this morning. So we're talking flea and tick control for summer, and this is a really big deal, especially in our areas. If you go out to the lake and there's lots of long grass, we want to make sure our pets stay safe.
Right. It's a really bad year because of all the crazy weather changes.
Sure.
It's probably been the worst year so far that I've seen. More animals have fleas and ticks on them than I've seen in years here.
That's alarming.
Yes.
Okay.
So make sure you take care of your pets.
Right, let's start with some of the remedies that you've brought.
So, you know, I always try to err on the side of natural.
Yes, possible. Of course, yes.
But I will tell you that natural is not necessarily a flea killer. It's a flea repellent. So if you want to put something on your pet daily that's safe, you can make something like taking apple cider vinegar, boiling some water and lemons and spraying it on your pet. Make sure the lemons don't dilute your pet's coat if it's a black dog.
Okay.
A lot of times I boil them overnight and let it seep and then put it just in a spritzer bottle. I also love essential oils. You can actually, Dr. Melissa Sheldon makes fabulous flea essential oils that are natural. Somebody's trying to tell us down here about flea control.
Hi, Nat.
And then neem and catnip are also excellent essential oils, but we do have the conventional medications as well.
Okay.
Make sure to check with your veterinarian. It's really important if your pet is not healthy to be careful about chemicals in your pet as well.
There are so many, I find, different kinds.
Right.
Well, how do you know which one is right for your dog?
Make sure to check with your veterinarian.
Okay.
These Bravecto and NexGard are chewables. There's a lot of bad juju out there on the internet about them. They are pretty darn good products. However, make sure that your pet is safe. And I always like to tell people, put something in your pet that's safe, like a liver detox or milk thistle, because a lot of these products can be metabolized through the liver. So we want the liver to be clean and we want your pet to be healthy as well.
You mentioned bad juju out there. Is that one of the things that they're talking about?
It is. It is. There's a lot of bad negative, but they're both excellent products in the right pet. I want to make sure people understand that. There's also the topicals. Nothing's without some form of poison in it, so you need to be mindful. These are some of the more natural products over here. The Vetra Repel, there's wipes. The neem spray is excellent as well. You know, nothing's going to get really the ticks so well off with the natural, but it will repel them.
What about the shampoos that you brought here?
Right. I make these shampoos. They have essential oil in them and hemp, and they're an organic saponified coconut oil, so they will repel some of the fleas as well. And don't forget your sunscreen. These sunscreens also that I make have flea and tick repellent in them.
If your pet is scratching a lot, that doesn't necessarily mean they have fleas or ticks, right?
Right. It can mean many other things, allergies as well. But if your pet's chewing and biting, especially at the tush or its feet or it's rubbing its face, take it into the vet. Make sure that they don't have fleas. A bath is huge. So make sure, you know, if you see your pet scratching and itching, give them a bath right away. Be careful what you're using to bathe as well.
Okay.
Because it's really important. Some people use human shampoos and it's not always right for your pet.
Okay, very good. Great advice as always, Dr. Jill. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. Martina, we got to keep Buster and Bolton safe from fleas and ticks this season.
We really do, especially because our dogs, you know what they are.